as a parent, I'm like, you know, how much of a risk are we willing to take when it comes to the safety of our kids?
Summer is just beginning, but school districts around the state are getting ready for students to return for the first time since health officials declared COVID-19 a pandemic back in March. Working for WRTV6's Troy Washington shows us what experts think of students returning to school and whether or not parents should send their children back in the middle of a pandemic.
Ultimately, these are case-by-case decisions that have to be weighed with the family to kind of make a joint decision on what's best for their particular situations.
This expert says the decision is up to the parents at the end of the day, and it all depends on the family and who lives in the household that could possibly be at risk.
The child I would consider not to be at a whole lot of risk. If that child lived with someone who was getting chemotherapy and had heart failure and was over 65 years old, all those things would be a little bit concerning to me, and I might consider the risk a little bit differently.
Dr. Cole Biller thinks there is a wave of coronavirus cases on the way, which is something parents may want to consider while deciding whether to send their scholar back to the classroom or keep distance learning.
I expect, in the next few weeks that we are going to be seeing more cases and that we are going to get a little bit of a flare.
But he says
it seems like kids are a little bit less likely to actually spread the disease than was originally thought.
Takiyah Lewis runs BK Interventions, an initiative designed to keep scholars soaring. She's also a parent, so she sees both sides of the debate over sending children back to the classroom during the pandemic.
In reality, I am a parent first, and I have to do what's in the best interest of my child, and that's the same advice that I employ others take as well.
Some schools have released return to school plans, while others are still at the drawing board. Those plans include making sure students are wearing a mask during the day, reserving and limiting spots on school buses, rotating playground zones, increased disinfecting, and not allowing school visitors. Dr. Cole Biller says some of those guidelines are realistic, others not so much.
Really, it's going to be very difficult to expect kids to keep masks on their face the entire day, and I think that's okay. Kids are mobile. Try and move things outside, you know, try and space things out as much as possible.
Working for you in downtown, Troy Washington, RTV6.